अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस पावर वर्ड सिमुलेटर ट्यूटोरियल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू परफॉर्म इकोनॉमिक लोड डिस्पैच और ऑप्टिमल पावर फ्लो एनालिसिस ऑफ IEEE 9 बस सिस्टम इन पावर वर्ड सिमुलेटर सॉफ्टवेयर। कंसीडर द फिगर व्हिच शोज द सिंगल लाइन डायग्राम ऑफ IEEE 9 बस सिस्टम। We have to design this model of IEEE 9 bus system and perform its economic load dispatch. Friends, at the first stage, we have to design the IEEE 9 bus system model in the PowerWorld simulator software. Later on, we have to perform its economic load dispatch. For this purpose, come to PowerWorld simulator software screen. You can see the basic model of IEEE 9 bus system is already designed here. Friends, in order to save the time, we will directly start from the economic load dispatch section. It is because I have already made the video on how to perform load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system in PowerWorld simulator software. Therefore, you can watch that video to design the model of IEEE 9 bus system, as well as download the IEEE 9 bus system model from the description section of that video. Let's start to perform its economic load dispatch or optimal power flow analysis. Double click on this generator 1 block and go to power and voltage control section. Here it asks about the generator maximum and minimum real and reactive power limits. From the IEEE 9 bus system data, the maximum and minimum real power limits for the generator 1 are 250 and 10 megawatt respectively, whereas the maximum and minimum reactive power limits for the generator 1 are 300 and minus 300 MVAR respectively. Furthermore, it has the maximum voltage of 1.1 per unit. Therefore, come to model again. Right here 10, again 10, and here 250, whereas right here 300, here minus 300, and here 300 MVAR respectively. In the set point voltage, right here 1.1 per unit voltage. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. Now click on cost block, then click on output cost model, then click on cubic cost model to put the cost function variables. For this purpose, look at the IEEE 9 bus system data. The variables for first power plant are 0.11, 5 and 150 respectively. Therefore, right here 150, here 5, here 0.11, and press OK. Now let's insert the data for generator 2. From the IEEE 9 bus system data, the maximum and minimum real power limits for the generator 2 are 310 megawatt respectively, whereas the maximum and minimum reactive power limits for the generator 2 are 300 and minus 300 MVAR respectively. Furthermore, it has the maximum voltage of 1.097 per unit. Therefore, come to model again. Double click on this generator 2 block and go to power and voltage control section. Right here 10, again 10, and here 300, whereas right here 300, here minus 300, and here 300 MVAR respectively. In the set point voltage, right here 1.097 per unit voltage. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. Now click on cost block, then click on output cost model, then click on cubic cost model to put the cost function variables. For this purpose, look at the IEEE 9 bus system data. The variables for second power plants are 0.085, 1.2 and 600. Therefore, write here 600, here 1.2, here 0.085 and press OK. Similarly, double click on this generator 3 block and go to power and voltage control section to insert its values. From the IEEE 9 bus system data, the maximum and minimum real power limits for the generator 3 are 270 and 10 MW respectively, whereas the maximum and minimum reactive power limits for the generator 3 are 300 and -300 MVAR respectively. Furthermore, it has the maximum voltage of 1.087 per unit. Therefore, come to model again, write here 10, again 10, and here 270. Whereas, write here 300, here -300, and here 300 MVAR respectively. In the set point voltage, write here 1.087 per unit voltage. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. Now click on cost block, then click on output cost model, then click on cubic cost model to put the cost function variables. For this purpose, look at the IEEE 9 bus system data. The variables for third power plants are 0.1225, 1 and 335. Therefore, write here 335, here 1, here 0.1225 and press OK. Now we need to initialize automatic generation control mode for the generators. To do this, go to field, then click on generator field and put it here at generator 1. A window will appear. Click on generator AGC status and press OK. You will see that AGC mode is activated. Similarly, repeat the procedure to activate the AGC mode for remaining two other generators. Now we have to activate the economic load dispatch mode in order to perform the optimal dispatch of generators. For this purpose, go to case information, then aggregation, click on areas, change the mode to ED, which represents the economic dispatch mode. Change the decimal to right of place to 2 for all the generators real and reactive power values in order to get accurate results. Now we need to find the total cost per hour for this model. To do this, go to field, click on area field and put it here anywhere on the screen. Click on hourly cost and press OK to measure the total hourly cost. To write its heading, go to background, click on text and put it anywhere on the screen. Write here total hourly cost and press OK. Now repeat the same procedure to measure the total load in megawatt for the whole area. Copy this text box. Write here total load and press OK. Now repeat the same procedure to measure the total generation in megawatt for the whole area. copy this text box, write here total power supplied and press OK. Now repeat the same procedure to measure the total losses in megawatt for the whole area. Copy this text box, write here megawatt losses and press OK. Friends, at this stage our model is completed. Now you can run the simulation. To do this, click on this run mode and go to tools and click on play button. You can see it has successfully performed the economic load dispatch. Now compare the total hourly cost, power supplied and losses measured by the software with the results obtained in the example. You can see all the results are accurate, even better than the actual results. Friends, in your case, the results may be a little bit different due to the fact that software measures the values randomly with different combinations to calculate the minimum cost. This is interesting. Actually, economic load dispatch belongs to optimization problem. In this optimization problem, our aim is to find the minimum cost in order to make the economic load dispatch cheaper. For this purpose, various methods are used to find the optimum dispatch of generators with the minimum cost. Therefore, in this case, it is observed that PowerWorld simulator software has obtained more economical cost compared to the cost obtained in the results. Friends, in this tutorial, I have discussed how to perform economic load dispatch or optimal power flow of IEEE 9 bus system in PowerWorld simulator software. For your convenience, I have shared this economic load dispatch model of IEEE 9 bus system as well as its PDF in the form of link in the description section of this video. You can download it from there. By following the same procedure, the economic load dispatch or optimal power flow analysis of any system can be carried out in PowerWorld simulator software. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.